Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Dory. I had vertical sleeve gastrectomy weight loss surgery on September 12, 2016 in Hartford, Connecticut with Dr. Darren Tischler. My highest recorded weight, which if you look back on my other videos, I always thought it was 333 pounds, but we went back, my gynecologist and I had went back into the records from maybe like 2012-ish, and it was actually 350 pounds. So my highest recorded weight was 350 pounds. My surgery weight, day of surgery, was 300.5. The lowest adult weight that I've seen after my surgery was 169.6. And right now I'm up a couple of pounds. I'm not sure. I kind of feel like I'm retaining water, or I feel a little bit more bloated than usual. So today I was 178.9. And, so basically I am, usually around 175. So it jumped, you know, a couple pounds here and there, from this weekend. I think I was, I don't know, maybe I had a little bit extra salt. I'm not really sure. I didn't go off the rails and go crazy train or anything, but I definitely was snacking a little bit more, and I wasn't preparing my meals, especially on Saturday. My husband had drills for the military this Saturday and Sunday, and, you know, of course, on top of him working during the week and then working, of course, this week, it was his drill weekend. So he wasn't home, and we had car trouble again. Within 1 week, my car is actually, it was towed on Sunday, yesterday. And within 1 week, I have spent $1,450 on the truck. Never ends. But like my husband said, it's our only transportation. It's all we have. His job is still being kind of crazy with the pay. I know in previous videos I had talked about that and how we didn't get paid for almost 6 weeks and all this. But as always, God always provides and always takes care of us. And so I wasn't really worried about it. And I banked money, became debt-free while he was gone, and yada, yada. And so now, you know, with the car problems, you know, that emergency fund is used up again. So anyhow, so that's a separate issue, but I wanted to come on here and do my weekly update. I really try to do it on Mondays because that was the day that my journey had all began. But anyway, so yeah, so let's get to it. My NSVs that I forgot to talk about the other day when I updated from my 5K, you know, you go, you register, and they ask you a shirt size. And so I always ask if it's true to size, or if they run small, they run bigger, whatever. And so I got a medium, and it really wasn't tight on me, as you can see from the pictures that I put up on that video of the 5K. And I was actually wearing a shirt underneath. I had a one of those like windbreaker type workout. I don't even know what they're called. But anyways, I had that. You'll see the collar of it. It was long sleeved. And so I had that underneath, and the medium was still, you know, not snug at all, which is fantastic. That I will take. I used to wear 2X, especially when there were t-shirts like, you know, a friend of mine, daughter passed away. She was going through cancer. And before that she had, you know, they had like a team, I think it was Lynn Strong, shirts made. And so, you know, you never know like what company is going to run smaller. And so I always got a 2XL. And so now to be in a medium, and I could have probably gotten a small, but I didn't want to push it. I wanted to be comfortable while I was walking slash running the 5K. And so that was an NSV for sure. Being able to go down to a medium shirt and feel comfortable with it. Also, another NSV is I went to see a concert this Saturday evening, and we went to go see, or Saturday night. It was Pentatonix, which is an a cappella group. If you're not familiar with them, please go on Google or YouTube and search them out, because They are amazing. The things that they can do and the instruments that their voice sounds like is just, it's breathtaking. It really is. I'll actually attach a couple videos to the end of this video of a couple of songs that they did. It was just amazing. It was great. And so the NSV was just be able to run in up and down the stairs, get out, have people come, you know, get into the seating. We were pretty close to the stage. We were off to the right of the stage, but right there, a couple rows up. And so, you know, people had to go between us and climb over us and everything when they were getting to their seats. And it was great. I didn't even feel like I was in anybody's way. Nobody said I was in their way. They came and went, you know, just normally. And then fitting in the seats was amazing. I know from previous years of going to different concerts and venues and stuff, definitely getting stuck in that seat or just feeling cramped up or like my hips getting kind of onto someone else's seat. And so I didn't even touch the ends of the seat on either side, which was fantastic. And one thing I'm looking forward to is next Tuesday, my 4-year-old, who is turning 5 tomorrow, so my 5-year-old is graduating preschool. And I've had a bunch of different, you know, a bunch of my other children had went to this preschool as well. Some had graduations and some didn't. But in this, it's actually in a, I forgot what they call it. It's at a high school, but it's in their auditorium. And I remember 3 years ago when my son graduated from this preschool, I remember not fitting in the seats very well and just feeling so cramped. And then previous to that, a year or so before that, my other daughter had graduated, and that was like horrible. That was, I was so uncomfortable. And, you know, it's like your blood circulation gets cut off by these arms on the side of the chairs, and it just was not good at all. And so I'm very much looking forward to just sitting in the seat and feeling so comfortable and feeling so confident at being able to stay in the seats during the graduation. But yeah, so we enjoyed the concert on Saturday. Yesterday was my son's birthday. He turned 8. And then my daughter is turning 5 tomorrow, so they're only 2 days apart. If she wasn't so stubborn with the last one, she would have been born probably the day after him because I was induced that day, but she waited a full another day before my labor really became active. So in any event, they are 2 years apart. Two days apart, one born in 2011 and one born in 2014. And so anyhow, so yeah, so that's that. We're planning on doing a birthday party for them. Very small, very low key. We do not do birthday parties like we used to. We allow the kids to choose their favorite meal, whether it's something we cook at home or a pizza or whatever it could be. Each of my kids are very different. And so we have told them that they can order or bake or make or whatever, any, you know, their favorite meal. And then they get, you know, of course, the choice of what kind of cake or no cake and just ice cream or an ice cream cake or whatever. And basically, we just invited a couple of friends over. And that's it. Very low key. No more of this going to Chuck E. Cheese, going to a bounce place, going to this and that. It's just too expensive with 4 kids and just trying to remain debt free and everything. It's just you got to cut where you got to cut. And my kids are happy and they're thrilled when they get to have their meal. And of course, my daughter who just turned 11, she basically gets the same, wants the same thing every year. And so she usually gets lobster and shrimp or scallops, and of course we get it fresh. My brother works for a large seafood distributor and restaurant here, so we get that fresh for her, and she usually has that with corn on the cob and pasta Alfredo, you know, with Alfredo sauce. And so that's kind of her signature meal every year. The seafood will change, but the pasta Alfredo and the corn on the cob never changes. And then, you know, my son likes McDonald's. He's the one who has autism, and has a lot of sensory problems, which if you guys have any advice for me, he's having a very hard time eating, where for the last 3 years, peanut butter and jelly all the way till the cows came home. And now for the last month, he will not touch peanut butter and jelly. He said his taste buds changed. He's on a pancake kick. And so it's pancakes with butterscotch chips in them every morning, every night. But the problem is that he's losing weight. And so I have him drinking Gatorade every day. I have him drinking, you know, his Propel water he likes. He snacks in between. He'll eat, you know, crackers, and he'll have, you know, like Cheez-Its and Goldfish, and he'll have peanut butter on graham crackers. He'll have Chobani only blueberry yogurt. He'll have Baby Bell cheese, something from McDonald's. He'll have chicken nuggets and sometimes a cheeseburger and sometimes fries. That will all depend, but it definitely, he could eat like 10 chicken nuggets. But I'm running out of options, and he's gone down from 54 pounds down now to 49 pounds. And so I've got to keep up with him. I have to try to do something. And he's very particular about this. He has sensory integration. So he's very particular about his senses and what he's chewing and the texture and then taste as well. And so if you guys, I know there's a lot of people who watch my channel who have a child or experience with autistic children or sensory or anything like that. If you guys have, like, you know, I don't want to give him Ensure because I don't think he'll like it. I don't want to buy it if he's not going to like it. I'm going to actually see my friend Jim at Absolute Nutrition and see if there's a high, you know, high carb, high calorie, maybe ice cream, vanilla ice cream flavored protein powder that I can give him, and maybe mix it in a blender with ice cream, vanilla ice cream or something. I don't know. I have to try to get some weight on him. He's, when I give him a shower, I feel terrible because he looks like, you know, he's just, you see his ribs and you see, you know, his chest bones here, and it's not good. So I'm trying to figure out what else we can give him. I've tried different things. He used to eat shaped mac and cheese because it's a different texture than the elbow mac and cheese. And now he doesn't want that. He'll take two bites and say he's done. And so, yeah, so I'm kind of at a loss. I don't even know what to do. And he won't really eat chicken nuggets from here, only from McDonald's. So, yeah, so that's on a separate note. If you guys can, you know, one, keep him in your prayers, and two, suggest something if you guys know something that he can eat that, you know, texture-wise or something like that, that he may, you know, want to do. So as far as eating, I have felt very snacky lately, very, I really have to make a conscious effort not to have it. I feel very weak in this area now. I feel very like if I give myself a tiny permission to have something, I'm gonna just blow it. I'm just gonna eat it, and I'm just, so when I'm thinking of it, like when I want to have something, I have to be very, very conscious of saying no, like a very firm no. Not even a bite, not even a nibble, not even a piece. So, you know, case in point, I own a cookie company. I make lactation cookies for breastfeeding moms. They contain organic ingredients and galactagogues. It's a fancy word for just foods that help a nursing mom produce more milk. And so I own this company. I've owned it since 2011. It's called, it used to be Making Mama's Milk, and now I changed it to Milk Boosters. And so I was making some, you know, orders this morning, and typically it doesn't faze me, but today I tried out a, I got an order for a, sorry, somebody's walking by my house, an order for pumpkin spice, and I use maple chips to go in it, and they just look so good and smelled so good, and in my head the whole time as they're baking, I'm thinking to myself, oh, I'm going to try one of these because, you know, hey, quality control inspector here, and I just want to try it and a nibble, and I just had to tell myself, no, I can't. And then the order before that was oatmeal raisin, and I pulled those out. And of course, you see the big, gigantic raisins, and they look so big and juicy. And then you're like, oh, this one's broken in half. I can't give it to the customer, so I'm going to eat it. And I had to consciously pick up that oatmeal raisin cookie and fling it into my garbage disposal. And then it had fallen into the sink, and I had just cleaned out the sink. So I knew the sink was, everything was clean, dry, everything. So I had to consciously dump some water onto the cookie to get it down the garbage disposal, because I just, you know, there's some days where you are on point and you know from the time you wake up to the time you go to bed, there is no cheating today. I feel satisfied. I'm going to have protein. I'm going to have, oh, I feel tired. Excuse me. But you feel like, you know, I am on it. I am not going to be tempted today. And then there's other days that you are like, holy mackerel, I am a bottomless pit and I'm just going to eat all the things. And so I didn't do that. I threw it away. I did not have the pumpkin one. I put it in a bag, text my friend who is a, she's the girl who I told you was a surrogate for a couple. She had the baby about 2 months ago, and she's nursing, she's pumping milk and sending it to the state that they live in every week. And so I give her the cookies, and so I text her right away, hey, I have this new flavor for you. I have a bag for you, you know, just so I know in my mind they're going where they need to go and they're not going in my stomach. So that is that. I'm trying to think what else. I feel like even though I'm bloated, I don't feel big, you know, anything like that. So if you guys could pray for my truck, my cousin is my mechanic. He's putting in a fuel pump right now. And I'm just nervous that something's going to go wrong. The fuel pump itself was like $300. And so if you guys can just pray for my truck, I need my truck back today. But yeah, I'm feeling like I woke up today with a migraine. I took 2 Excedrin migraine. I took a ibuprofen. And of course, I'm sure some of you, as you heard that, thought, oh my gosh, it's an NSAID. She cannot have NSAIDs. Well, we can have NSAIDs if we couple it with a Prilosec, which is doctor ordered, from my surgeon's office as well as my PCP. And so basically that's what I do when I have to take a migraine medication or I have to take ibuprofen, whether I have a muscle sprain or like I pulled the muscles in my stomach that time, anything like that. And I have to take them. I take them. I don't suffer. I know there's people who say no NSAIDs. It's a crock. I'm sorry. I'm almost 3 years out and I've done research and I have an amazing team, whether it's my surgical team or my primary, but in any event, if you take a Prilosec, the one time that you take it, don't make it a regular routine, but you could do that for 2 weeks straight and not have an issue, whether you're RNY or sleeve or lap band or whatever it is. As long as you couple it immediately with a Prilosec, it just protects, and there won't be any kind of acid and all that could erode your esophagus or whatever. But anyhow, so I took that this morning and I still felt it. We're getting rain in the forecast for later today. And so I'm like feeling it. So I stayed home, of course, because I don't have a truck. I didn't get to go to the gym, which is fine because with the migraine, I would not have been able to do anything anyways. But the last couple nights, I have not been able to get to bed early. And so I'm averaging 5 to 6 hours of sleep for the last 3 nights. And so tonight, I'm planning on going to bed early, getting some rest, being able just to get 8 hours sleep if I can, and then start my day anew tomorrow. Last night, I got up. My Fitbit needed to be charged, and so I got up to go downstairs thinking that my band was down there, my charger, but in actuality, it was not down there. It was upstairs in my bedroom. But while I was down here, I thought, well, let me do all these dishes, dry them, you know, wash them, dry them, put them away, do some laundry, get the backpacks ready for school, get the school clothes ready, get, you know, laundry folded and like all this stuff. So I did everything last night, and I didn't get to bed till a little after 10. So tonight, hopefully, will be a better night. And that's it for now. Hopefully, in my next update, I will be down on the scale a few pounds. And also, too, I have a video coming. I was chosen by a company called Health Warrior to be an ambassador. So they sent me my welcome kit. I'm going to try the product on camera, let you guys know what I think. And yeah, so that's it for now. I hope you guys have a wonderful week.
Yeah.